Thank you. the Heifetz International Music Institute and its Festival of Concerts. More than 50 live concerts in Stanton, Virginia, and daily programs streaming worldwide. Full calendar and information at heifetzinstitute.org.
Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Heifetz Festival of Concerts 2023, Stars of Tomorrow X, marks the spot right here, Francis Auditorium on the campus of Mary Baldwin University. I'm Benjamin Rowe, the president and CEO of the Heifetz Institute. Welcome to all of you here in Francis Auditorium. Welcome to all of you streaming us live on Facebook Live and on YouTube. And welcome to our artistic director, Nicholas Kitchen.
Well, it's wonderful to just think how many pieces of music we've all shared in this space and in all these wonderful forms. Tonight's going to be no exception. You know, there are these magnificent pieces like the Brahms Sonata that's going to start the first half, the Fauré Sonata that's going to start the second half, pardon me, and the Fauré Sonata that's going to be in our first half. It's kind of nice to think of the program starting and finishing with these two very charming and kind of memorably sunshine-like pieces, the G major violin sonata, the Haydn cello concerto in D major. And of course, a piece like the Zai that will be before the intermission is just a beautiful kind of expression of virtuoso violin playing, just magnificent. And then, you know, it may be that some of you have heard the Bowen sonata here at Heifetz. Some of you may have heard the Bach's sonata as well. It's been great to hear violists kind of explore these works, but at least for me, they're not terribly familiar, but I'm just loving getting closer and closer to this really a very imaginative music. I hope you're kind of feeling the same with that. And well, I guess that pretty much covers everything that we're hearing tonight. I can give you a little warning that one of the pieces you're going to hear tomorrow is going to have bells in it. But I think for now, we've just got a wonderful program. The students, the young artists are just doing so beautifully. It's amazing that it's been 5 weeks and there's just so much activity. I know every so often people are looking a little bit ragged around the edges. But in fact, I think everyone's going extremely strong, and I know we're going to have just a gorgeous last few days of the Heifetz Institute 2023. So welcome to the concert.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Ian, and I'm from Hong Kong. Wonderful pianist Rohan De Silva and I will be playing the first movement of the 8th Violin Sonata by Beethoven. This movement is filled with joy, excitement, and energy, which always reminds me of my playful younger brother. We would always laugh at random stuff and make terrible jokes. So I would like to invite everyone to think of your own fun experiences while we play. Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Joy Say. I am from Atlanta, Georgia, and I am 24 years old. Tonight, Tay and I will be performing the third movement of the Viola Sonata by Arnold Bax. Arnold Bax is a British composer, and he wrote this piece in 1922. The beginning starts off very strong and declamatory, and in the middle section, the piano part has a very intense moment without the viola. And at the end, melodies from the first movement are brought back. This movement to me is very emotionally complicated and filled with nostalgic memories. Thank you.
I'm Daniel. I'm 23 and I'm from New York. The wonderful Jessica and I will be playing the first two movements of Fauré's first violin sonata. There's a magic about this piece. Those aren't my words. Those are Camille Saint-Saëns' words, who was a great friend and mentor of Fauré. Fauré studied with him at Paris Conservatory. And after Fauré graduated from Paris Conservatory, he lived a modest life as a church organist and as a teacher. So he didn't have that much time to, you know, compose financially. So he did all of his compositions in the summer. And I think in this piece you can hear, even though it has really dark moments, there's this long kind of color of summertime, just like how the days are longer here. This is my fourth summer here in Stanton, so excited to play for you. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Jihyun Baek, and I'm from South Korea. I'm 24 years old, and this is my first time at HIFES Music Institute. Today, Greg and I will be performing an Etude Caprice written by Sing Songs and transcribed by using Ijai. An etude is like a short musical exercise that helps musicians to improve their skills. Sing Songs originally wrote this piece as an etude for pianists and specifically said after studying of the waltz form. Even though Eugene Ijai transcribed it into this version for violin and piano or orchestra, it is still challenging for violinists to have a technical freedom within the waltz form. Personally, this piece has been a quiet journey for me with so many upside downs. Some moments I really try to challenge myself and improve, develop my technical availability through this piece, but it really didn't settle with me. However, now I'm bringing this piece back on this stage to show myself as a performer and the delightfulness of every little moment of this piece. Thank you. Thank you.
interesting things happening on tomorrow's program. Like, literally, you'll see somebody with bells on their toes. But that's actually, I think, a harbinger of just saying that during the last week, all kinds of interesting and unusual things take place. So you really want to make sure that you're here for the final series of concerts. We have all kinds of things planned for you. And I also realized that as we were talking about, as we pick up with the intensity of concerts, if you happen to be looking at the back of your program, I noticed that we actually left a concert off. So, as we mentioned, we have a bonus Stars of Tomorrow, which, if my math is correct, is July 25th. And July 26th, we will also be back here with another Stars of Tomorrow concert, which is not listed on your program. But I promise you, our musicians are getting ready for it and gearing up for it. There's some very interesting things that will be happening on that night. On the 27th, that is a Thursday, there's actually three events going on. We're going to be at the Public Library in Crozet with one of our many outreach concerts this summer, as well as the Junior Division bonus concert at 1 o'clock at the South Market Stage at Grace Christian, and then at 7:30, our final Chamber Music Showcase, which will feature the students of our Chamber Music Seminar, and really something remarkable that evening, a complete performance of the third Brahms String Quartet and a complete performance of the third Shostakovich Quartet. Those will be happening on Thursday. Friday is our Friday in the Gallery, our final Friday in the Gallery, and I know that we have some fantastic quartets that have been working very, very hard under the tutelage of the Borromeo String Quartet members. They're giving their final concert on Friday at 1 o'clock at the Gallery. And the evening, we'll be concluding things in our celebrity series with the magnificent first sextet by Johannes Brahms. Remember, we heard the second sextet near the start of the season. So we'll have that. Thomas Mesa will be playing some wonderful solo works, and some other things are on the hook for that concert. And then Friday, the Junior Division has a chance to strut their stuff both in a chamber music concert at 11 a.m. Lots of free coffee for that one. 2 o'clock in the afternoon for the solo showcase, more free coffee and ice cream for that one. And then our grand finale, and I should use the full title, the grand finale and farewell toast. And I can vouch personally for the farewell toast part because Costco got very rich off of me over the weekend. In case you're wondering the provenance of where the toast is gonna come from. Anyway, some marvelous things are truly on tap for this final week. And I think just to underscore something Nick was saying, that I've been just so thrilled at the remarkable level of energy and camaraderie that we've felt with our student body and faculty this year after the last couple of pretty challenging years. This has been such a wonderful chance for, I think, faculty and all of you and our staff, and our outreach concerts have really, I think, produced a wonderful feeling of summer here in Stanton, and I will just underscore how lucky we all are. Okay, one last little bit about week six. It's on the back of your program. I don't need to say much more about that now, but I'll be saying more later. Thank you, and enjoy the second half.
Peter Yablokov, and tonight Tae Kim and I will be playing the first two movements of the Sonata in F minor, Opus 120, number 1, by Brahms. The first movement, the title says it all. There is plenty of passion and vigor and energy in all sorts of different forms. And in the second movement, I like to think of it as an older person reminiscing on different stages of their life. So for example, in the beginning, it might be when they're young and more vibrant. And there is an extra special section in the middle where in the written music, the piano actually changes key signatures, but the viola doesn't. And so it kind of creates this mixed reality feeling where one of the instruments is often this fantasy dreamland while the other one is more grounded in reality. I just think that's some interesting food for thought, and thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Robert Fornos, and as of earlier this morning, I am a 19-year-old violist from Miami, Florida. Today I'm joined on stage with the wonderful Tae Kim, and we will perform the first movement of the first viola sonata in C minor by York Bowen. Bowen was an English composer, and he was active in his work between the very early 1900s up until his death in 1961. He dedicated this piece, which was written in 1907, to the great violist Lionel Tertius, who, thanks to his efforts, shaped much of modern viola playing. This piece for me was one of those that I fell in love with at first sight. Or more accurately speaking, it was love at first listen, which was actually a performance here at the Heifetz Institute last summer. I feel like Bowen in this particular movement of the sonata really makes use of the high and the low registers of the viola in a way that there is a very wide character dynamic. So in the high parts, you won't only get very dramatic and intense sections, but also kind of this feeling where you could imagine a very calm bird flying through this forest, but also the very low registers making use of the deep and rich sound that the viola is capable of producing. Before I actually start performing this piece, I want to give thanks to my parents, because while it might be my birthday, this particular year marks a very important milestone in that this will be my 10th year playing the viola. So when I say this, I'm like eternally grateful to them for sticking by with me for such a long time, even though they may have had their doubts in the beginning. And of course, to my younger brother, who can attest to the fact that I practice a lot and has endured countless hours of painful intonation practice and different exercises and etudes, and worst of all, especially during the pre-screening season, sitting next to the camera and filming me while I was recording myself play. Anyway, I hope my performance today shows you why I love this instrument and why, in particular, I love this piece so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Alexandra Lukashuk. I'm 19 years old and from Fairfax, Virginia. And today, Yoon Lee and I will be performing the first movement from the Cello Concerto in D Major by Haydn. This is a particularly special concerto for us cellists because we're all scared to play it. Well, it presents a lot of cool technical effects and fast runs, but nonetheless, it's still a very beautiful concerto and presents and has and explores a lot of amazing sound worlds. Haydn wrote this concerto for a very prominent soloist of his time, Anton Kraft. We can see with all of the brilliant technical effects that this concerto was certainly made to be played by a talented 18th century soloist like Anton Kraft himself. So, but I've had a great time working on this piece with Miss Lee, and I've really grown to love this piece over the time that I've been working on it, so I'm very glad I get to share this with you all tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.